MetaHuman Creation has finally come inside Unreal Engine. With the new MetaHuman Creator plugin in Unreal Engine 5.6, you can customize and animate your characters without leaving the engine. In this full guide, I'll walk you through the entire process: plugin setup, customization, animation, and export tips. All right, let's start by creating a new project using the latest version of Unreal Engine. Now, the first step is to open the plugins window. I'll do that from the bottom right pop-up that says Manage Plugins, then just search for MetaHuman and enable all the related plugins. Once they're enabled, go ahead and restart the engine to apply the changes. Now open the content browser, right-click, go to the MetaHuman section and choose MetaHuman Character. You can name it anything that fits your character or project. Double-click to open your MetaHuman and you'll likely see a prompt in the bottom right corner. Click Enable Missing, and if Unreal asks for another restart, go ahead and let it. After the restart, we can customize our MetaHuman. First up, just like before, we've got presets to choose from. But now you can also customize the body shape and even the head shape, making it easier than ever to create a stylized character with the new MetaHuman plugin. Before you pick a preset, keep in mind, it'll automatically add a hair groom asset to your MetaHuman. And every time you change the body or face, it has to rebind those groom assets, which can slow things down a bit. But for this demo, I'm going ahead and using a preset. Just give it a moment. It'll fully load the preset shortly. Loathing is added automatically, but you can hide it by going to the right side panel, finding the Outfit Clothing section, and switching the visibility from visible to hidden. There are plenty of body presets to choose from, but since this video is all about customization, I'm going to click on the Model button. That's where you'll find all the detailed body shape options to tweak and make it your own. The Global section lets you adjust the overall body shape all at once, perfect for broad changes before diving into the finer details. Sometimes when you make changes, the clothes might reappear, so if that happens, just go back and set the clothing visibility to hidden again. Next, we've got muscularity. You can increase or decrease it depending on the look you're going for with your character, whether it's lean, bulky, or somewhere in between. If you're creating a dwarf character for your game, you can drag the height slider all the way down to shrink the body proportionally. I'm fast-forwarding through this part because the settings here are pretty basic. You can easily explore and tweak them on your own. Don't get me wrong, I love watch time and ad revenue, but there's no point yapping for hours without giving you the value you came for. Let's move on to the head section. Just like before, you've got plenty of presets to choose from. But if you want more control, you can switch to transform or sculpt mode to start customizing the face in detail. Sculpt mode lets you refine even the smallest details of the face, perfect for fine-tuning expressions, features, or stylized looks. And in transform mode, you can easily change the overall face shape, great for quickly adjusting the character's structure before fine-tuning the details. I don't need to make any changes here, so I'll jump over to the eyelashes section and pick the ones that best suit my MetaHuman. The eyelashes aren't visible right now because I hid the groom assets earlier while adjusting the body, so let's re-enable them from the right side panel. Once you're done sculpting the face, it's time to move on to the materials section. Here, we've got a body texture index to choose from. These control the overall skin texture and detail. Just pick the one that fits your character best, whether you're going for something realistic or more stylized and humanoid. I'm going with texture number 3 for the body. Now let's pick a texture for the face. Let's zoom in so we can see the changes more clearly. There are a lot of face texture options available, so take your time and choose the one that best fits your character. Texture number 5 looks really good to me, so I'm going to use that for the face. There's also a texture position offset option here. I tried adjusting the value, but it doesn't seem to make a noticeable difference to the texture, at least not in this case. If you want to reduce wrinkles or facial marks, you can use the texture index filter. It helps smooth out those details for a cleaner look. Next, we can choose the skin color. This is a key step in defining your MetaHuman's overall look and feel, so take your time to find the tone that fits your character best. Next, we've got the freckles section. This lets you add or adjust freckles on your MetaHuman's face, giving the skin more personality and natural variation. You can control the intensity and pattern to get just the look you want. Next is the accents section. Here you can select specific parts of the face, like the cheeks, nose, or lips, and adjust redness, saturation, or lightness to add more depth and character to your MetaHuman. We also have a texture override option here. This lets you manually apply a custom texture to your MetaHuman's face, completely replacing the default material. It's especially useful if you're going for a unique style, using hand-painted textures or matching a specific character design. Next, let's choose the eyes for our character. There's a variety of eye colors available, so pick the one that suits your MetaHuman's style and personality best. We've got the eyelashes section here, but I'm not making any changes to that. So I'll move on to the makeup section. I'm going to remove all the makeup that was applied by the preset. But hey, if you want, this is where you can go all out and make your character look straight up ugly. Totally up to you. Next, we've got the hair assets. I'm going to browse through and pick the hairstyle that best fits my character. If you want to change the hair color, head over to the details panel. From there, you can adjust the color of all the groom assets, like the eyelashes and eyebrows. I also want my character to have black hair, so I'll make that change here too. All the groom assets are listed here by name, like long curl or eyelashes in brackets, and it's the same for hair. Just find the asset you want to recolor, then use the color wheel or enter a hex code to pick the exact color you want. Once the color is set, you can also go ahead and pick a specific eyelash style if you want to customize that too. She actually looks pretty nice without eyebrows, but let's reapply the eyebrows. I also want to make a very slight adjustment to her face, just a small tweak to refine the look. I'm done customizing my character, and now, before we finalize the MetaHuman, there are a few final steps we need to follow in the right order. First, download the textures. I recommend using 4K resolution here. 8K textures might look tempting, but they can cause crashes or be difficult to optimize, whether you're building a game or rendering a cinematic. Downloading textures can take some time depending on your internet speed, so just be patient while it finishes. Now that the textures are downloaded, you can go ahead and click on Create Full Rig to finalize your MetaHuman. This process can take some time as well, so just be patient while the rig is being generated. Once this is done, you'll probably see an error, but don't worry, you can safely ignore it. Just like we all ignore the fact that Unreal Engine loves to ship updates with something broken. Now you can check the status in the MetaHuman viewport to see if the textures are properly applied and if your MetaWoman is fully rigged. Next, head over to the assembly section. Here, you can give your character a name. Once that's done, click on Assemble. This will generate all the necessary files in the content browser. This process can take a bit of time too, so just wait for it to finish. Once it's done, make sure to save your MetaHuman character and close the window. You'll now see a new folder called MetaHumans in your content browser, and inside you'll find your customized character ready to drag and drop into your scene. Now let's create a sequence and test it out to make sure the MetaHuman's control rig and face rig are working properly. As you can see, this MetaHuman has a perfectly working rig. Everything's functioning just the way it should. But don't worry, the video's not over yet. There are still a few more things I want to share with you guys. To dress up your MetaHuman with custom clothing, you'll first need to remove the default outfit that comes with it. To do that, go back to your MetaHuman character and head over to the hair and clothing section. Now just scroll down to the bottom of the hair and clothing section. You'll find your outfit listed there. Double-click on it to remove the clothing. Once that's done, head back to the Assembly section. Don't change anything. Just click Assemble again to update your MetaHuman. Now we can close this window and you'll see that our MetaHuman is fully ready for export. Now select your MetaHuman and export it. And just like I mentioned in my last video, always reset the location and rotation to zero before exporting. Some of you didn't listen and ended up exporting without resetting, which probably caused your MetaHuman to vanish somewhere in Metatailor while trying to dress it up. Don't skip this step. It saves you a lot of confusion later. After resetting the position and rotation, make sure your MetaHuman is still selected, then go to File, Export Selected, and just copy the export settings I'm using in the video. Once that's done, export it. And now we're ready to import this avatar back into Metatailor. Now I'll go to Import and select the MetaHuman I just exported from Unreal Engine. And now our MetaHuman is successfully imported. We're all set to start dressing it up right here in Metatailor. Metatailor can lag a bit when dressing up a custom MetaHuman, especially with complex assets, but hopefully that's something they'll smooth out in future updates. Most of the bones are usually in the correct position, except for the nose tip. So make sure to fix that before moving on to the next step. Now let's switch to the Design tab. I've already got multiple dresses in the content browser, and all I need to do is click Apply. The outfit will be added to the character perfectly. Now I'll head over to the Export tab. Here I'll choose the export path and give the outfit a name. Since we're using Unreal Engine 5.6, make sure to leave the rotation fix option unchecked to avoid any issues during import. Make sure to copy all of my export settings exactly as shown in the video, and once everything's set, just click Export. Let's go ahead and close Metatailor, then jump back into Unreal Engine to import the outfit. Create a new folder for your outfits if you haven't already. I've already got one set up, so I'll import the outfit directly into that folder. I'll also drag the MetaHuman to the side, so I can clearly see how the outfit looks once it's imported. Here I've got the FBX file, so I'll just drag and drop the outfit into the content browser. Once the import prompt appears, scroll down to the Skeleton section. Select the MetaHuman base skeleton, and then click Import to bring the outfit correctly. We also need to import the textures. It's a pretty basic step, so I'll fast forward through it to keep things moving. Now that texturing is done, I'll head into the MetaHuman blueprint. Click the Add button, then search for Skeletal Mesh. If your outfit was imported correctly, you should see it listed by name. Just select that Skeletal Mesh to add it to your MetaHuman. Now just click Compile and Save, and your MetaHuman is all set with a custom outfit, ready to go. Now, if I go to the sequence and move the MetaHuman, you'll see the outfit moves right along with it, just like it should. Let me move to the other side of the MetaHuman and adjust her leg, so you can clearly see how the outfit moves with the body. Now, what if you want to remove the MetaHuman's undergarments? To do that, let's open up the MetaHuman character again. When you reopen the MetaHuman, you won't be able to make changes directly. First, you need to remove the rig. To do that, just click the Remove Rig button at the top. It might take a little time, so just wait for the process to finish. Now go to the Materials tab and select Skin. In there, just uncheck the Show Top Underwear option, and that will remove the top. Now just save the character, click on Create Full Rig again, and you're good to go. Your MetaHuman is updated and ready for action. Keep this in mind, guys. Every time you want to make changes to your MetaHuman, you'll need to remove the current rig. And if you want to use the character in-game or in an animation, you'll have to create the rig again afterward. That's why I recommend finalizing your character before creating the full rig. All right, that's it for this one. We've gone through the full process, customizing your MetaHuman, dressing it up in Metatailor, and handling the rig and export steps. But if you guys want a full deep dive, like complete character customization, custom outfits, custom hair, and more, I'll do it. Just get this video to 2,000 likes and 49,679 views. You know the deal.